Hi. That's a big bow. It doesn't show.
Customize the project, and that's something our
the other works they do not do. But also this is maybe confusing for the user that just wants to use that. And we also have another configuration then about the simultaneous search. We do not do backtracking, and this is essential because high dimensionals, when you do backtracking in the game tree, then this reduces to almost a slower performance than brute force search. So this is very essential. And also all trees are visited in order. So actually you gather from every tree some candidates, and then you visit the most promising ones. In high dimensional space, what is very expensive is a distance computation. So we actually provide some methods of casting the distances and skip whatever we can, so that we get the distance computation be faster. That is very essential in high dimension. We also provide a public domain single file software and a web app where you don't have to download the project. You just upload your files and you let GeRaF find the nearest neighbor for you. We also provide a very good performance. We have the fastest building among all other state-of-the-art software right now. And the scalability is also very critical, both on N and D, where N is the number of your points and D is dimensional, the dimension of your points that they live in. So on randomization, which is the most powerful innovation that we have, is the rotation. Before building a tree, we rotate the dataset so that every tree is based on a different dataset, so that it actually utilizes different dimensions. That helps to build uniqueness. Then the split dimension. In a traditional RKD tree, what you do is that you pick dimensions in an order. Here we do not do that. We actually pick the tough dimensions of highest variance, where D is a user parameter, and or actually our software can auto-compute with that. And you actually see which dimensions have the highest variance, which means that these dimensions can provide more information, and you pick only that. So when you choose, when you choose randomly a dimension, you choose only among these dimensions. Then the split value. We split on the median in the axis that they selected with the split dimension. And instead of actually splitting the dataset in the median, we actually add a term delta that is in that range, which is the diameter of the current points set up, so that you actually don't split at the median every time, but you have a distortion. This also provides more unique tricks. And the sampling is also a very helpful idea, because the median, especially when you have images and codings, may be witnessed in several points. So if you actually sample the points, then you may pick one point and then another. So you actually then construct more unique tricks. This is the building that I said. You actually pick the highest variance, you transform the data set, and then you actually build the trees where you choose one dimension at random, then you find the median with quick select. It's only linear in time, in size. So then you split. The same thing. First, we descend every tree, we store branches, we don't look leaves at that point. We saw them in a mean priority queue, which actually provides an order. So then we descend again, and we start popping up branches from the queue, so that we actually visit the most promising ones, because we do not want to search all the branches. There may be many of them. So we have a parameter again, not configured or manually set. That is C to 1 plus epsilon, and we want to check only a small amount of leaves, but only the most promising ones. And when actually we descend a tree, if it's a leaf, then we actually check the distance. I mean, like you do in the brute force, and we set it in the heat. If it is a node, then we check this if it is the negative last space of the node, and if it is, then we set the right child to Q because it might be promising as well. And we descend to the left child in order to descend it. And vice versa if the query is in the positive last space. The implementation provides a plethora of parameters, but I'm going to show only six of them. M is the number of trees in the forest, but notice that the overhead is not very much because points are stored only once. TAF is the number of dimensions used for splits, as I mentioned before. P is the maximum number of points per leaf. And C is maximum number of leaves to be checked during sales. That is what we had here in the second bullet. That's it. Okay. Epsilon determines the search accuracy from the definition in the slide 1. The less the epsilon, the more accurate you are, but also the slower. And K is the number of neighbors to be detected. In comparison with other softwares, K does not affect our performance. It is almost the same for us to find two nearest neighbors and 10 nearest neighbors. Of course, if K is very large, then of course it will dominate. The remark is that the quick select algorithm pays how you find the median fast. We reduce the distance computation, as I said before, which is very important. And the viral distribution. So here are some experiments on the Oxford dataset with core features. You see that they will have to actually be many trees in some situations, like 64 to 5, but our accuracy is zero. Zero, I mean, the miss is zero, so our accuracy is the maximum. And here we provide the experiments of the sieve and the yeast encodings. So GeRaF is the purple one. You see that it provides, a very good trade-off between accuracy, which is on the x-axis, and execution time on the y-axis. And in conclusion, GeRaf is a very efficient implementation, and it is very competitive against the state-of-the-art methods. It provides an advanced parameter configuration that's actually the fastest right now, and it will not be the bottleneck of your algorithm. And lastly, the competitive methods have difficulties because they are inconsistent, maybe in the search and the configuration parameter. And sometimes the configuration parameter doesn't even finish for the other.
Okay. Thank you very much. Are there any questions?
No. No questions. So let's continue with Arthur Truong.